Crank asks, how is the easiest way to measure roll center on a car and what to look for? So what Crank is asking about there is, I'll start talking about what a roll center actually is. So if anyone that doesn't know already, so essentially there's a roll center defined for each end of the car, both for the front and the rear axle. And the concept of a roll center, it's actually an imaginary point in space. It's not something you can physically measure. It's a construction that you make from measuring other parts of your suspension. The idea behind it is it's the point that the car rolls about in space at each end of the car. So the car's not rolling about at center of gravity when you go into a turn. It's actually rolling about this thing we call the roll center, which the other important point to understand about the roll center is it's not static. It's constantly moving both up and down and side to side as your car rolls and moves through the corner. But the idea is at each point in the suspension travel, that it's the instantaneous point that it's moving about each end of the car. The important thing to understand, it is a big part of your what we call your geometric weight transfer. So there is weight transfer through the elastic elements, which are things like your springs and your anti-roll bars, bump stops, stuff like that. That's what we call the elastic elements of the suspension. There is also geometric weight transfer, which is heavily impacted by the position of the roll center. Now, the easiest way to, on Crank's question, is the best way to measure the roll center. So that's something you have to calculate. As far as calculating it statically, it's relatively simple. Essentially, you take into account all of your suspension pickup points relative to some reference. So usually it's, to start with, it's the ground level. So that's a case of measuring their vertical position from the ground and their horizontal position from the center line of the car. So if it's A-arms, that's both inner, both inner pivot points for both A-arms and the outer pivot points for both A-arms. If it's McPherson strut, obviously you have to include the top pivot mount as well. And using that and the track width, it's actually really pretty easy to sketch out on paper if you can take some basic measurements of your car and construct where the static roll center is. Now that is one part of the puzzle, but the more interesting part is actually determining how much it migrates. And all I mean by migrate is how much it moves as the suspension travels. Now you can absolutely calculate this by hand on pencil and paper, and it is actually quite a useful exercise to go through to understand how all of this works for yourself. But this is where really simulation can come in and might be a really powerful tool for understanding the roll center migration. So it doesn't have to be a really involved process. Simulation can be anything as simple as a basic spreadsheet that you make yourself, or there are plenty of really affordable spreadsheet based tools that you can buy already that have been available and well developed for a really long time, right up to incredibly expensive supercomputer level simulations that are taking into account a whole lot more than just the roll center. But there's a massive wide spectrum of the types of simulation. The beauty of that simulation is that any point in the car's orientation is at its position on track. The idea is that you can see how much it migrates. The thing that stuffs a lot of people up with roll center is that people think that when they lower the right height of their car, they're lowering the center of gravity, and that's going to improve the performance of the car laterally and longitudinally. So in principle, that's sound reasoning, in that the weight transfer, which is something you want to reduce because of the vertical load sensitivity of the tires, when you lower the center of gravity, you're essentially, in theory, you're reducing the weight transfer. And that's true. The weight transfer laterally is dominated largely just by the height of the center of gravity and the track width, and longitudinally is the height of the center of gravity and the wheelbase. But the important thing to understand is when you take, something that's based on a road car that you're taking to the track, you lower it, and that's true that you do lower the center of gravity. But what happens with road car kinematics, and all kinematics means is the way the suspension moves through its different arcs, depending on the geometry you have in your car. When you lower the suspension, you generally have a lot of roll center migration. And the reason for that is, in OEM cars anyway, is because the suspension arms are typically really short. The problem with that is you get a huge amount of roll center migration. They're short because of packaging reasons that you get for road cars. So, you know, in road cars, you've got really different goals. You're trying to fit lots of passengers and gear on the inside. You've got to make room for the engine compartment and passengers' bags and all that stuff. So as a result, the suspension arms being relative to something that would be purpose designed for racing, the suspension arms end up being really short. Short suspension arms tends to give you a lot of roll center migration. The problem is with roll center migration is the thing that determines the amount of one of the things that determines the amount of body roll you're getting is the height difference between the center of gravity and the roll center. So The problem with roll center migration when you lower the car is if that was your center of gravity and that's your roll center height, these are the wheels out here. When you lower the car, the roll center it'll go a lot lower than it was originally, and that roll moment is defined by the height difference between the center of gravity and the roll center. So you've lowered the car, now your roll center is down here. In theory, you've reduced some of the lateral load transfer, but you've also increased the moment arm between the center of gravity and the roll center. The problem with that is now you're actually going to introduce, for all other things being equal, you're going to introduce more body roll as a result, and you're quite often going to end up with worse performance just because you've now introduced a whole lot more roll into the car, regardless of the fact, and you're going to lose everything that you gained by lowering the center of gravity. So as a result, you'll quite commonly see for commonly modified cars, roll center correction kits, where it's essentially about correcting the geometry of your car. So that, as far as your questions of what to look for, if you have lowered your car and it's something that's based on a road car, if you've lowered it, you should definitely be looking at a roll center correction kit. If you like free stuff and you'd like to learn more about optimizing the performance and handling of your car on the racetrack, as well as improving your skills behind the wheel, then we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description of this video to claim your free spot to our next live lesson. You're guaranteed to learn a lot, and you'll have a chance to ask questions which we'll be answering live. Remember, it's 100% free, so click the link to claim your spot.